is Black Abyss. I have not had this before. Okay. We could talk a little bit about this cigar here. It is my first time smoking on this one here. Let's see. This Black Abyss cigar, this is a Robusto, a 5x50. It has a two bands. Okay, I already took this one off. Okay, we don't need that one. That's just for decoration. This is what it looks like. Okay. Small, easy, should be pretty easy to smoke within an hour. Okay. They call this the Banshee. It seems kind of off-putting. Why would I want to smoke a Banshee? Is it going to scream? Is it going to be annoying? But we'll see. We'll see how it tastes. Let's see, what can I tell you about this cigar here? I believe the tobacco here comes from Nicaragua. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm looking at here. The Dominican Republic, actually. Dominican Republic. Okay. All right. It says that it's going to have a full strength, but we'll see that. We'll test that out, definitely, for sure. Maduro shade in the wrapper. Okay. And let's see. This is produced by Jose Blanco, who's a famed master blender responsible for the highly rated either in aging room blends. So if you like those, you'll definitely like this. And it's pretty cheap. Pretty affordable, I would say. A pack of five would cost you, if you go to JR Cigars, which they might as well just promote me since I'm promoting them, would cost you $24.50. Actually, sorry. That's the retail price. The JR price would be $17.70. Look at that. That's not bad at all. I mean, if you go hit up a Specs or a Total Wines or whatever cigar store you go, you probably spend $5, $6, $7 on a basic cigar. Maybe you spend $10 on one that you really want to cherish. If you have the money, maybe you go $15 on one. The most I spent on one cigar was, I think, $17. And the cigar was this. But it was really, really good. And it was made in Texas. it was like, what? Oh, I see OBS is dropping frames. So here we are again. It's red, but it's not. The stream quality isn't dropping to where it's just gonna be absolute crap. This is nonsense. I feel like I'm taking crazy pills over here. I feel like I'm constantly dealing with this internet tech issue, and it's like maybe it works whenever it wants to, and it doesn't work whenever it wants to. So it's like the singing frog thing, if you know what I'm talking about. You know, Looney Tunes. Not Tiny Tunes. So, this cigar has a decent taste right from the bat. Okay, just wet in a little bit to punch it. All right. Now you know what? Let's go match. Let's light this up with a match. Let's light this baby up with a match. And let me know how the stream is looking. All right, I'm lighting it now. I might need another match for that. This contraption, it's in the way. All right. Get it all nice and lit. You don't need to puff on it to light it up. You shouldn't need to. For proper cigar etiquette, if you care. If this isn't working, I'll just light it up. Well, it looks good so far. Yeah, that's not bad. Yeah, that's nice. That is a nice full flavor right there. This is sort of a cigar. Being a Maduro, these go really well with coffee. I mean, they really go well with that. Yeah. There's a little sweetness to this. Now, the sweetness is nothing compared to this one. I really enjoyed this one. This is actually one of my favorites. You can't see it because of the glare. And I'm not going to wrap it yet. Insidious by Asylum. That's one of my favorites. That's one of my prefers. Only because it's sweet. It's the sweet that I like. But not too sweet. There's a little sweetness in the taste of the tobacco. Okay, now I like my cigar. You might like your cigar, or maybe you don't like your cigar. That's fine. My wife obviously doesn't. You ask any guy who smokes cigars, their wife probably hates it. Probably hates it. Right. But here's the thing. I tell my wife, like, hey, it's my vice. It's my thing that I do. Right? I smoke about like one a day, maybe two a day if I'm really feeling it, right? It's my vice, whatever. I'm not inhaling. People say, oh, it's not healthy for you. Well, actually, to be that guy, nicotine does have some health benefits. Oh, I don't know about health benefits, but does have benefits to it. Actually, health benefits. Nicotine straight up without tobacco, with ingested, has, you know, benefits for your brain, for the aging of your brain. Being able to store and recall memories. This has been shown in studies. Of course, they'll say, but it has to be taken purely because they don't want, you know, the tobacco, other ingredients to be, you know, part of that mix. But the reality is, if you take it directly, and that's what nicotine does, then of course it's going to do the same thing if you get it through, let's say, a cigar. And true, you're not inhaling the cigar. Of course, you're smelling it, right? The tobacco is around you. Like on a good stream, when I'm firing this up just right, you could see the smoke. Right? It's great. It's great. I love that. Like that right there? That's good. That is good. Let's see. Oh, the other benefit though. Oh, well, let's go with nicotine. Yeah, sure. Nicotine raises your blood pressure or increases your blood pressure a bit, but that's not always a bad thing. It can actually kind of like ease your tension away. It can actually make you less anxious. It can actually calm you. It's weird how that works, but it does. Can calm you in a way. Increase your heart rate, shit, and then not blood pressure. Sorry, my bad. I misspoke. Increase your heart rate, which increases the speed of sensory information. So, okay. That's cool. Processing things faster. The other thing is really taking, you know, setting the tobacco or sort of the nicotine aside. Just, cigars are not something you smoke real fast and be done with. This is something you smoke and you're just chilling, you're relaxing, you're soaking in the environment, you're pondering about things, you're thinking about things, you know. It's like meditation. It is like meditation. But more practical. And without the hallucinogens. Come on now. Come on. There's people who meditate on huacua, whatever that's not what you call it. Or people who meditate on magic shrooms. Come on now. Are you meditating? Are you just having like enjoying some crazy inner show of fireworks or whatever, some inner freak show thing? I mean, come on. Inner light show. That's what you're enjoying. Anyway, but you know what? Your thing is your thing, right? Right? But yeah, a good cigar, good whiskey. Those are things that, to me, add just extra value to life. And maybe that seems like whatever to you. It's like, are you kidding about that? No, I'm not. Like, a good cigar is something that really.